Hey, everyone, Andrew here, bringing you another video review, and today we're going to be doing my Andrew Cutter Picks of the Weeks, along with news and updates. Now, for those of you that are new to my channel or don't know anything about this video series, my Andrew Cutter Pick of the Weeks is a video where I take a look at this week in DC Comics. Then I talk about the week and pick out the comic that I enjoyed the most and call it my Andrew Cutter Pick of the Week. In addition to that, I also do any news and updates that have to do with my channel. If at any time you want to see a full in-depth review of any issues talked about this week in my Andrew Cutter Pick of the Week, you can just look in my previous videos. I reviewed them all. So, with that said, I do have some news and updates that I want to talk about, some ideas that I want to throw out, and also I want to, of course, get into this Andrew Cutter Pick of the Week session. First and foremost, I wanted to say sorry I didn't get the comic book reviews out on a timely manner. I've been busy a lot with school, and you guys got to understand it's my last semester, and it's getting towards the end of the last semester, and I have a lot of group projects to do. Right now, I was doing a group project for my marketing tactics class, and it's kind of been stopped right now because everyone's trying to do separate parts and we all have to do the parts together. And I decided that I threw out the suggestion to everyone that we should just meet on Monday and do it. But I have that, and then I have my managing teams and projects group project to do. I have tons of group projects to do, and then I also have to do my strategic management group project. So I have a lot of group projects to do. So I'm just busy, and then I also had I've been I'm not gonna lie, I've been playing a lot of this, and we're gonna talk about this today. So with that said, let's just get into this week in comics. Now, for me, this week for DC Comics, I had a Batman: The Dark Knight, and again, all these are issue number threes. Superman, Aquaman, Flash, The Savage Hawkman, All-Star Western, Voodoo, Justice League Dark, and finally, the Teen Titans. This week in comics was a pretty good week. And it was an interesting week because usually when I look towards the comics that I'm probably going to enjoy the most, I look towards kind of Justice League base members like Superman, Batman, Wonder Woman, Flash, Aquaman, Green Lantern, Hawkman, so on and so forth. But surprisingly, the comics I enjoyed the most this week were comics like All-Star Western, Voodoo, Justice League Dark. They were really fun comics. Batman: The Dark Knight is getting a little bit better. A little bit better. It's still the weakest of the Batman family. Superman didn't get better. It was actually a little bit of a drop-off. Aquaman was fantastic as always. Flash was pretty good this week as always. Savage Hawkman is kind of doing a roller coaster. It's good then bad then good then bad. It has its ups and downs, and I think the series will get better after we deal with the first story arc. All-Star Western is a good comic, just not as good this week as it was last week. Voodoo surprising me and turning out to be a really fun comic just to read on the side. Justice League Dark was definitely a great comic this week, and Teen Titans got better with the introduction and with a few new characters, particularly Bunker that I like. He's a very I don't know, he has a very cool personality, and it's just fun to see him interact with Tim Drake. Now, when it comes down to this week, there were three contenders for my Andrew Cutter Pick of the Week. Voodoo issue number three, Justice League Dark issue number three, and Aquaman issue number three. After taking a look at it in detail about which comic I enjoyed the most this week, it was really tough. But I have to say, the comic I did enjoy the most this week, and it is Aquaman issue number three. This comic consistently turns out to be one of the best of the DCNU, and I recommend it to everyone. Voodoo was a great issue, and Justice League Dark were good issues too. I just think Aquaman was just a little bit better. Geoff Johns is really working well with Aquaman on this, and I'm glad to see Aquaman's getting some notice now in a very serious sense. If anyone ever had their doubts on Aquaman, don't read this. Have those doubts go away. Amira is absolute badass in this too. So on a whole, this was a pretty good week for DC Comics. Nothing really bad at all. Everything is either getting better or is already good. The only thing that kind of made a small drop off was Superman and a little bit All-Star Western, but more Superman than All-Star Western. But both were okay comics. So that's this week in DC Comics. As for news and updates, first and foremost, the most important thing is I've been playing Zelda Skyward Sword like crazy. They say it takes 50 to 100 hours to beat the game. I've been playing for about 32 hours. I've had school and work and girlfriend and stuff. But I'm almost done the game and I'm almost 100% complete. All I have left is a bottle, a few heart pieces, some gratitude stones, to upgrade my bomb bang and my sea snatchel and the Hylinean shield. Other than that, everything else has been completed. So, in saying that, I'm going to continue to say what I've been saying. I said in my previous video about this, my first thoughts. This has been one of the best games I've ever played, if not the best game I've ever played. It is currently taking the reins as my favorite Zelda game, and if I do a review of this in its entirety, do not be surprised that I keep that opinion. This game has been fantastic. Fantastic. Really enjoy it. Really, really, really enjoy it. So I think, I mean, I have a lot of schoolwork to deal with, but I think I will be able to complete it within the next week or so. Because, like I said, I have a lot of schoolwork to deal with. Any other updates? Small little updates here and there, but for one thing is I'm going to do a few helpful videos to you guys. Hopefully, I've been getting a lot of questions from people that are getting into comics or getting back into comics that want to know, and let me just adjust this, that want to know what comics to pick up for the DCU and on a tight budget, and also how to read comics. So what I'll do is I'm going to do a informational video either this week or this next week talking about how you should collect comics, what's the best way to go. Issues, trade paperbacks, hardcovers, and if you go for either venue, what should you pick up? And how should you buy things? Should you buy stuff at a comic store? Should you buy stuff online? Should you go to Comic Cons to get stuff? What sales to look for? And also how to protect your comics. For example, for comic book protectors, and a lot of people say that this is pretty standard knowledge, but it's not necessarily always standard knowledge. I guess I can throw this out here real quick. Is for covers and backings, there's three styles for the type that I do. Let me see if I have any of the the stuff is out of the reach. But the style that I use uses three different kind of styles: gold and silver and modern. Modern is more for individual issues, and the back again, this is for the covers and the backings. Individual issues. Silver can be used for silver comics, but they also are good for trade paperbacks. And golden is for Golden Age comics, but they're also good for hardcovers. I'll get into that a little bit more detailed when I do that video, but I'll do that and I'll also give suggestions for someone who's tight on money. Basically, the five comics that you should pick up for the relaunch, depending on what you want to go for. Do you want to aim for diversity in your comics? Then I'll give you a standard superhero selection, maybe a more of a horror comic, and then a team-up comic, and then maybe an on-the-edge comic. Do you want more of a Batman feel? Then I'll give you the five Batman comics you should get. Do you want a feel from the Justice League? Do you want kind of a Justice League feel? Then I'll give you a Justice League and the five Justice League members that you should read and do something like that. If you want to go really out there and go for completely new comics, I can give you some of the top new comics that you should read. So just general suggestions and stuff that hopefully can help you guys out. Of course, the basic thing that I always tell people is that no matter what, just pick up stuff that you like. But I will be doing that video, and I will be getting into that sometime. I want to kind of finish Zelda first. I got WWE 12. I only got to play 2 hours over it over my girlfriend's house because I'm focusing on Zelda. I will not play another game until I beat Zelda 100%, complete it. But I played 2 hours of that. Not really too impressed. It feels kind of like the previous game. It's not bad, but it falls under the Madden football game kind of problem where it's the same game, just slightly better than the previous installment. Not enough to wow us, but enough for us to want to buy it. I also got Assassin's Creed Revelations, but I haven't played that because Legend of Zelda. And I've had to put my Skyrim on hold. Anything else? Ooh, gum. Oh, and there's still gum in there. A little surprise. I was surprised because one day I was going through my old pockets on one of my jackets and I found $10. That's good. Let me see. Anything else off the top of my head? Because I did have some news and updates, but I completely forgot it. I am going to do that video series. Nothing else, really. I guess Harry Potter. I know I haven't been able to do reviews of those lately, but like I said, I've just been kind of busy. So I'll probably do a review of those during December when I will be done with school. Other than that, there's nothing really else to talk about. Just slight news and updates here and there. This week, hopefully, I'll be able to get my comic reviews out on time. I will post up Grifter number 3 tomorrow. I've been really lagging on that Grifter review stuff, but I'm doing issue number 3, which will also cover issue 1 and 2, which Grifter is a decent series, so I'm gonna post that up and see what you guys think, and hopefully I'll help you guys out. Other than that, there's nothing really else I can say. I've just been really busy, and I hope you guys thank you for understanding, because last semester of school I had to focus on being good. So with that said, I'm gonna end this video here. This is Andrew saying peace out for now.